In this tutorial, I'm going to show you how to monitor your home or office using your computer's webcam. Sit back and relax while thieves break in and steal your stuff. Let me take you to the future and show you what great success awaits right after you've finished this tutorial. I am going to log in and launch my program, which I created just now. Then open a web browser and see my valuables being robbed. Before getting started, make sure you've installed GoCV correctly. I will add a few links that explain how to install it in the description. Watch me write the code really quickly. First, make some variables and define command line arguments to secure the webcam feed. Here, you need to set up a username and a password because we don't want people having access to our camera. Create the main function, then add a few functions to show errors. The main function checks the command line arguments and show the help message when the help argument is used. Afterwards, prepare the camera. Prepare the motion JPEG stream and the Go routine that process the video frames. Now, we'll set up a web server that uses HTTP basic authentication to secure our video feed. Finally, let's add all of the required library imports and voila, the program is ready. I'm going to explain a few important sections of the code. This section sets up the video capture device. To use your main web camera, set the device ID to 0. The device ID value can be changed later to use a different camera. This Go routine is responsible for the most important things happening. Here we check if there's been a video frame and if there is. We encode it as JPEG and send it to the motion JPEG stream. Finally, in this section, we set up the web server to serve the video stream through the net. If you want to find all my mistakes in the creation of this program, check out the errors video. Thank you for checking my tutorial and happy coding to everybody. A link to the source code is in the video description. Please like and subscribe if you want me to show you how I set up a motion detector in my next tutorial.